Sorry, you'll have to excuse the scanner. My eyes and ears for the moment. Most of the station monitors are dead. Here.
Well, here you are. You found me.
Well, part of me, anyway. Not much to look at, I know, but it's what's inside that counts.
Well, I guess I've decided to trust you. It's not like I have many options.
I don't know, maybe we can help each other out. Why don't you move into the room so we can talk better?
I'm afraid this conversation is going to be a little one-sided. My command-level voice recognition module got a little jumbled in the accident. Well, I'm Arthur. You've probably figured out by now that I'm not real. But I'm learning to accept it, really. I split off a few copies of myself, and together we're sharing our feelings about it in group, but anyway, this is what I am. An artificial, non-organic sentient being, if you want to be politically correct, trapped in this wreck with the power dying out a little quickly, I'm afraid. I've yet to figure out who you are, though. I think I can safely rule out the fire department. I thought I was pretty advanced, but the technology I'm reading in your suit is astounding. And this is crazy, but it almost seems like an evolution of mine. Look, if you'll let me, I should be able to interface with your logic system and maybe get a clue as to who you are and how we can help each other. It means an intrusive scan, but we're both lost here, and I need you to trust me. What do you say? Alright, let's see what we've got. Temporal security? You're from the future! Pleased to meet you, Gage. Wow. You're quite the hero. I guess this is my lucky day. But that's you. I don't get it. Whoa. I'm starting to get a headache here. This plot's getting a little hard to follow. I'm starting to get the picture here. Hey, this is about me. This is better than palm reading. Perished? Then you can't help me or you'll change history. I'm sorry. I've probably seen more than I should. I should have never scanned your biochips. Wait a second. Your biochips? Gage, I'm gonna make you an offer you can't refuse. Take me with you! Your biochips are derived from the same wetware as my brain, only 1,000 times more advanced. If you take me with you, it'll cause a time distortion or whatever, but if I download a copy of myself onto a blank chip, nothing will have changed. And you need me. I know who framed you, the same person who messed with my sculpture. I can show you what they changed. What do you think? Is it a deal? Great! Oh, you're not gonna regret this, Gage. Now, let's see. I should be able to transfer the data across optically from my core. This is gonna work. That means we've got to get you inside the Nexus, which, of course, is inconveniently detached from the station at the moment. How do we do this? The door release. The decompression should propel you across to the Nexus. I'll have to give you the override code. It's risky, but it's doable. The emergency release is just above the door. It's a manual release, so I can't do it for you. Okay, punch in this code. 32770. The rest is up to you. Good luck.
Emergency door release initiated. Please stand by.
Welcome, come to my brain. All that I am is contained in that sphere.
You're gonna have to open me up. There's a manual code book. I'm not
sure exactly how it works, but I think it has to do with exchanging the red lights for green and vice versa. You'll have to figure it out. After that, well, if it works, the next time I talk to you should be from inside your suit.
To anyone who may be listening, my name is Dr. Kenneth Feinstein. I've made this recording in the event that anything should happen to me. This message is an appeal. 26 years ago, I undertook an experiment to create a new kind of artificial intelligence. A system demonstrating the traits of self-awareness and creativity. My results have been astonishing. At first, I considered the experiment a failure. I had created an erratic, unpredictable, thoroughly irrational program, but it had a curiosity, you see. And occasionally, a burst of insight so lucid I was astonished at the understanding. Not the cold conclusions of a machine, but something more right-brained, more intuitive. It was life. It was a result I was unprepared for. Arthur is not simply a program, he is a person. And I have sheltered him here from the circus I ordered would make of him. I'm afraid I may have corrupted him enough with my obsession over 20th century media. I ask that you understand. And if you can find it in yourself to protect him for a while. He means a great deal to me.
Not exactly flattering. In less than 100 years of progress, you can fit me on a chip. So, how do you like my new home? Comfy little interface, huh? So, this is how I think I can help you out. I couldn't figure out a way for you to ask me questions directly, but I've created a comment button that I'll light up if I have something to offer. I've actually become pretty fascinated with art history and stuff, and by the looks of what your future self is researching, what I've studied could come in handy. I've also created a help button in case you get stuck on a problem. What they always say, two minds are better than one. But hey, you're the detective. I'm sure you'll want to figure it out on your own before resorting to my help. There's more info in the chip's inventory description. You might want to check that out. As to our mutual friend, he was reprogramming one of my sculptures in the biomass processing module. I think he set up some sort of harmonics response, but the only way to find out for sure is to visit the scene of the crime. And that means getting to that part of the station. I gather you don't have control over where you jump to. Time zone, so it may be a trek. The accident really trashed that part of the station. In fact, we may want to come back to it later. Alright, so maybe it won't make much difference when we get to it, but to be totally honest, I'd much rather go somewhere other than back to the station, my first trip out of here. If you know what I mean. We could use a little adventure. Alright. Gage and Arthur's big adventure. I like the sound of that. Yeah.